A sea pirate killed two army. The Nigerian army went and burned down a whole village in Biafra. Why? When there was a protest and when, you remember when a general was in a black case, the man was found in a well. The neighborhoods were found by the well, nobody was even arrested. But if it's in a jolla, they will go out and burn the whole village that the retired general was found in the well. A former chief, army chief, defense chief was killed badly. The Nigerian government went and investigated and arrested those who were responsible. Why can't they do that in other activities to go get all of those people? Because they are not ready to do these things. You must call a spade a spade. Don't lie. Don't think we are fools. Bade was killed. And how long? Within a short period, the people were arrested. But other people, they cannot get the people arrested. They go and do bon. Why always bon? Where's the laptop? So please, we must learn and let us, anybody who said I'm a leader of my tribe, you must get, as a leader, get to the grassroots. You must be in control. Not only coming to talk in seminars and talk without getting to your people. That doesn't show good leadership. Because you are not in control. You only talk and tomorrow people are posting the papers. If you are a leader when you talk, you must get back to your village and get to the last place in the village. You must be in control of your village. So what we are doing here, please, I am appealing that everybody wants peace. Even the man in the war front, the soldier who fights, wants peace. He wants to rest. He wants to rest because I was in the army for several years. I fought for in Liberia, I fought for Israel. And then through the Guyana Declaration, then they started these things of resource control. How can now somebody say an oil block in Biafra is owned by somebody in the north? Like, you're not done it anywhere. Don't seem to say it. It's not fair. And look at the mining in Zamfara, the diamond mining. The retired generals bought lands and the mining is for individual, those ones. But the one for this other one is because we are puppets, that is for everybody. Have them there, we live in a fair. Please, if we want peace in Lagos, every part of Nigeria must be peace. That is the basic truth about it. We must live peace, we must live as love, but we must bring more ideas and experts to go about it. But to summarize everything, let me stop here. God bless you.
Thank you very much. I'm very grateful. We want to recognize the presence of Mr. Eril Oluwole, President of the Lighting Council and National Chairman. Is the position of every nationality to that guy of Nigeria. Thank you, President.
Thank you.
Thank you, you are welcome. Now, we want to listen to Mr. Sowore. We want to have one or two things to say. Thank you, Mr. Sowore.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor. I want to say good afternoon to our elders on the high table. First off, it's good to see you. And to our Nigerian brothers and sisters, what I have to say is not much. I think we are wasting too much time having conversation about the Nigerian state that has completely failed. For a nation state to be worth calling a nation, it must be able to protect its people. The Nigerian state cannot protect anyone. It can't protect Yorubas, it can't protect Hausas, Fulanis, it can't protect people in the Niger Delta region. The truth is that while we are here discussing the enemies they chose for us, we have forgotten our real enemies. Those are the people in government. They are the ones manipulating us against each other. They are the ones choosing our enemies for us. When it suits them, they will give them a name that is popular. Now it is Fulani Herdsmen. There was a time it was OPC. There was a time it was Niger Delta Militants. There was a time the popular name was Unknown Gunmen. That is how Nigeria operates. That's how Nigerian leaders operate. And if you are here discussing the issues without attacking the problem, you are helping them to continue the enslavement of the Nigerian people. The truth is that there is no social, political, and economic justice in this country for anyone. And when you don't have that, people are going to be looking for who to attack. Imagine how a Fulani herdsman will carry K-47 from Sokoto or Borno all the way to Ebonyi, and nobody will apprehend him on the way. And when he's apprehended, somebody goes to the police station to rescue them. Because one of the things you don't discuss is that those cows that the Fulani herdsmen are heading around, they belong to rich people. They belong to government officials. Why are we deceiving ourselves? I know of a place in Oyo State. The people they call Fulani herdsmen have never passed Niger State before. They were born in Yoruba land. But you go and give them 10 cows, 20 cows, 40 cows, they will help you rear it. Kill anybody that is on the way of those cows. And when those things happen, you call them Fulani herdsmen. But meanwhile, they are Oyo State indigenous. You understand? Our position is that Nigeria has reached a tipping point. Nigeria needs a revolution. You are wasting your time. This number of complexes will not solve Nigeria's problem. I applaud our elders. You have tried. Prof here has been serving Nigeria head since you were in your 20s. You are almost probably 90 now. And you are still helping us to do conferences while the youth are hanging around, hoping that Nigeria will change. So let me just announce very quickly that starting from Monday, a group that I belong to, Coalition of Revolution, of four revolution, will be shutting down Nigeria from August 5. And this series of marches and rallies will continue until we have a Nigeria of our dream. I have lived in America for 20 years, so nobody should preach to me life or enjoyment. There's nothing there. The place to be is Nigeria. But we are running away and dying in the Mediterranean Sea because this country is uncomfortable for anybody. It doesn't matter your ethnicity. When they are not doing it in Fulani's name, they are using Operation Python Dance in the Southeast. Like our brother here just said, they just burned down a village in Bayelsa State. If you look at the soldiers that did it, they are not likely Fulani soldiers. It might be your brothers that burned down your village. Because there's no respect for our dignity as a people. And for you to get back your dignity, do as they are doing in Hong Kong. Do as they are doing in Algeria. Do it as they are doing in Tunisia. Do it as they are doing in Puerto Rico. Let's all come out one time, shut down this unworkable system. Once and for all. And then, after then, can we have a country in which the people decide their constitution, not the fraudulent constitution that was set up by generals in the army. Not this unworkable system. Nigeria itself was set up as a business by the British through the Niger Company. Nigeria was set up as if it's supposed to be shop right for the British. Nigeria never had the opportunity to become a nation. It's still being run as a business. That's why people are telling you that they own oil blocks, they own granite pyramids. No country should have its fate determined on products or commodities. But the problem now is that all of us, Nigerians, as we call ourselves, we have become commoditized. They are just trading us in the market of impunity. And until we retrieve our humanity and our dignity, we can have a million of these conferences. I've attended a lot of them, I can tell you. Starting from 1993 at the University of Lagos, when I was a student leader. Then our problem was also attributed to some Fulani generals. But when Abiola was going to be incarcerated, it was Yoruba of us that were going to Asoro to watch one stupid movie. They said they have seen what Abiola did wrong. The man who took over from Abiola was from Abel Buda, not the Fulani herdsman.
The Attorney General that became deputy to Abacha was from Ogun State, not a Fulani headsman. Let us stop allowing them to choose our enemies for us. Let us focus on the enemy we know, and not the enemy we don't know. Revolution now. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
The fact is order.
That is my answer for that word.
Please. Let me just.
Comrade, let me ask a question.
Yeah, go ahead.
We are in a dilemma. Fourth is right. Let me be right. Because today is the fourth time. What's clear deal? Fourth, sir.
We are in a dilemma.
This dilemma is paradoxical. And it has moved to the realm of paradoxical metaphor.
Some of those who are condemning this constitution today are the same people who presented this constitution and defended this constitution. I will give an example. Your friend, Chief Jordan, was the Minister of Information in 1999, before he became the Minister of Information under Abdul Salam Abubakar. He was a university lecturer. He taught law at the Enugu State University. He's a lawyer by training. He was a former minister of Nashagari, so he knows what he was doing. He took the constitution, raised it up, defended the constitution as Minister of Information, and said the constitution was the people's constitution. On record, he was Minister of Information who defended that. He was the Federal Executive Council that approved that constitution. Today, he's a member of the Southern Leaders Forum. And he has repeatedly said it is not a people's constitution. You can't blow water and go. Nobody takes leaders that blow up and go serious. That is why those oppressing us are not taking us serious.
That's right.
Those leading us are just, anytime they have their disadvantage, they are not in government. They claim to be the spokesmen and women of the people.
Yeah.
Anytime they are incorporated, they cease to become spokesmen and women. It's a paradox. So, in terms of mobilizing a revolution, revolution is a double edged sword. It can kill the revolutionary. It can kill the target of the revolution. So that we must be careful, those who want to recruit into the revolutionary movement, so that we are not slaughtered on our path to Petersburg in Russia. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. I want to quickly answer your question, sir, that this is not the time. You have been telling us the same thing since I was born. I was born after the war. When I went to primary school, they said we are leaders of tomorrow. Went to secondary school, leaders of tomorrow. University, leaders of tomorrow. Master's degree, leaders of tomorrow. Even I ran the election last year, they said it's not yet my time. I'm 48 years old. Grew up here, actually was a senator at the age of what, sir?
At the age of 43 or so.
Yes, I'm 48 years old. And they are saying that we should wait again. Yes. You may want to wait, but we cannot wait any longer. Not one day longer. Because it's our future that is at stake.
Yeah, right.
Regarding you, sir, and the fact that revolution is a double-edged sword, the current situation we are in is a four-edged sword. Anywhere you hold, it will kill you.
So I would rather go with the double-edged sword than continue to live with the four-edged sword that Nigeria has become today. So don't worry about who will die. Are we not even dead in this country? We are dead alive. You don't know how you can make it home as you are here. Maybe you are flying. How are you sure that even from the airport to your house, a Fulani herdsman, according to them, will not jump out of the bush and shoot you? Is that the revolution that killed you? It is the lack of revolution that will kill all of us. It's the revolution that can save a majority of Nigerians. That is the position. So, as for us who are planning it, we have recruited people already, and we hope you join us. That's our position. The young people in the Southeast who are doing IPOP, they are no longer afraid, because someone who is not afraid of death cannot be threatened with death. That is the truth. And for this country to move forward, some of us must sacrifice our blood for it. I never knew I would live to be 48. So I'm living beyond even the time that I had estimated. I could have died beside Abiola when I was 22 years old in 1993, where they were killing anybody who's opposed to the government. It was in this country that they were shooting people on the street. Kudira at Abiola, the people that shot them, they are getting national awards today. And I am not one of the people who recognized the 1999 constitution, sir. That's Nwobdo. That is the business they do, speaking from both sides of their mouth. That's how they make their own existence. It's the reason why I don't join the bandwagon when they were shouting restructuring. I know that Nigeria needs restructuring, but the people who were marshalling the arguments were waiting to join PDP, PDP's candidate. The other people who were against restructuring were in APC. When the PDP people get into power, they will never talk about restructuring, because an article can never restructure Nigeria. That will mean that he loses his business in Lagos and in River State. That is what restructuring means. But the man that's making $1 million per day, would he ever restructure Nigeria when he knows that that $1 million will now belong to the people of Lagos or River State? But they were deceiving all of you during the election, articulating and hyperventilating everywhere. The moment you lose out of this thing, you become the people's champion. The moment you win, you become under people. That is not who we are. I have history of about 30 years of blemish. I've never served any government before, sir. Never. I've never respected. In fact, I've never been to a government house before in my life. But I've existed on the fringes of this society, and we are tired and saying enough is enough. As simple as that. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mr.
We would like to recognize the presence of President President Supreme National Governor where he did this, and he stand up for recognition.
And we also have the leader of Apekoya, Shiko Shobi, and the Yalu de Apekoya, the Yoruba People's Congress, and we also have Shibakibulu, who is the Southwest Professional Forum President. I think we just like to, because we have a training session, then we have the leader of the Yoruba Ocean Movement, Wale Balogu. It's so great of you, eh? So we just take about 20 minutes now for question and answer, so we can break into our special guest will go, and we can break into the session. Just one or two questions, you know, then we can go, please. Take questions, please.
One, Okay, yeah. We should go.
Wow, my great comrade.
Thank you, sir.